world is at a tremble with its strength and mighty power. They're sending up to heaven to get the brimstone fire. Take warning, my dear brother, be careful how you plan. You're working with the mighty power of God's own holy hand. Atomic power, atomic power, was given by the mighty hand of God. Atomic power, it was given by the mighty hand of God.
Welcome to Southeastern Washington. We start our tour here in Richland, on the freeway that is both U.S. Highway 12 and Interstate 182. From 1943 through 1945, over 50,000 people flocked to the arid country of rural Benton County, Washington, to do something no one had ever done before. What's more, over 99.9% of them had no idea what they were about to do. As you take this journey, look for green and white milepost markers at the roadside. We'll use these mileposts to inform you of impending landmarks or places of interest. The first one you'll see will be in about 1 1/3 miles on the right, at the Exit 7 Road 100 sign. It will be milepost 7. Just south of here, and visible on your right, is the confluence of the Yakima River and the Columbia. You are now crossing the Columbia River on the mile-long Lee-Volpentest Bridge. You're leaving Benton County and the city of Richland for Franklin County. Soon you will enter the city of Pasco. It's part of Washington's Tri-Cities of Kennewick, Pasco, and Richland. About 6 miles north of here lies the south entrance to the U.S. Department of Energy's 560-square-mile Hanford site. During World War II, people flocked here to build and operate nuclear production reactors to produce the synthetic element plutonium for the most secret weapon, the atomic bomb. Two tiny villages, Kennewick and Richland, and the little railroad town of Pasco, became mid-sized cities almost overnight. Two other villages, Hanford and White Bluffs, ceased to exist altogether. Their sites became part of what was then the U.S. Army's Hanford Engineer Works. More than 50 years later, Hanford is still in the nuclear business. During the post-war decades, production fluctuated according to the Cold War's temperature. The peaceful atom also came to Hanford. Today, Washington Public Power Supply System Plant No. 2 generates enough electricity to power 500,000 all-electric homes. The tall columns of steam visible to the horizon on your left on cold days comes from the cooling towers of Whoops 2, as this generating plant is nicknamed.